This is the BBC Light Programme. Come, let us roll up our trouser legs and reveal the contents.
Mr. Greenslade! Cover those revealing off-the-shoulder socks.
I'm sorry, but I must cut down on spices.
Be on your guard, then. Now kneel down and say after me, I am shorter than Harry Secombe.
I will never sink that low.
If you don't acquiesce to my demands, you'll get jelly up your vest.
I warn you, Mr. Stitchelclume, that the practice of inserting jellies up senior announcers' vests is punishable by death.
Why, is it harmful?
Death is very harmful.
And pushing a jelly up announcers' vests?
It can ruin a jelly for life, to say naught. to say naught of its effects upon enunciation.
Yeah.
I pray you listen to this rare recording of such an occasion.
This is London calling in the Brown Euphonium service of the Bar BC. Here is an important announcement. At 6 o'clock this morning, I fell off the top of St. Paul's. Will anyone who witnessed the accident please phone Scotland?
A fate worse than death. He passed away that night in the direction of Down.
Thank you. Mr. Sellers, forward with your hand and knotted legs.
My music, please, minstrel. Ah, that music. It's 1899 and always on time. It comes from Winchelsea in the heart of the Brown country. A typical English village with a population of 8 million, two-thirds under seven. From time to time, nothing happens.
But it always gets into the Sunday papers, mate.
I don't suppose we'll ever stop it in Winchelsea.
Look. 1 2.
So you have, Henry.
How many months is he now, Min?
439.
So he's 37 years old, is he?
Yes. Dib, dib.
Listen, Auntie Min and Uncle Hen. Oh. I know you love children, but isn't it time I was weaned?
Listen, Min, he's trying to talk. Oh.
I can't go on kipping in this pram. It's had 10 extensions already. People are starting to talk. Another thing, I can't go on wearing nappies any longer.
Long nappies are a must with you.
Oh. It's embarrassing, I tell you. Look what happened to it in the Paul Jones last night.
You won a spot prize?
Yes, but what a spot to pick.
Let's go in and I'll show you how to bend mangoes. Forward with leather.
They've gone in, folks. Now's my chance to escape. I'll knock the nappies and slide down the pram. Oh, no. That would leave me starkers. And there's frost about.
I travel the road in a military way. I travel the road in a military way.
All day long you'll see me down the old road. And when you see me, I'm on the road.
Here comes a man pushing himself along on a piano. I must say he's a funny shape.
Skull me frogs and sorts me blue. What's this? Here's me regimental tape measure. 3 foot by 3. Either it's a tall child or a short man.
I'm the latter.
Oh, we must be related. I'm a former latter, you know. I retired, the strain became too much for me.
Then those lumps on your head are not fakes.
What a practiced eye you have, dear lad.
It's been practicing all day. Listen.
Really?
No, re mi fa sol la ni no.
Oh, yes. What?
Oh.
Yes. I'll have 5 of those, please. What? That lovely thing around your neck.
A gold chain. It belonged to my mother's throat.
Oops! Oh, dear. It's broken, and what do you know? It's fallen straight into old Dennis's deed box. Oh, dear. Oh, dear, dear, dear. Do you believe in miracles, lad?
Help me escape, and you can keep it.
I'll not be party to such a crime. Let me tell you, sir, that I am in the process of finding King Arthur's lost sword.
Let me join you. I'm facing in the same direction. What could be better?
Spoons on you, spoons.
Splin.
Have you ever had any experience in King Arthur's sword finding?
I took a course in it of Oxford, you know, and was sent down with flying colors and a pound of 24-hour quick dry licorice.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, but does your granny wear a bowler?
Side saddle.
Then you're my man. Come now, hold this outboard motor.
Help, murder, thieves, Lord, dear. Oh, the child gone. Gone and never called me mother. Oh, dear me. Hello, darling. Hello, police, rail. Hello.
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 Police, rail and fire station here.
Oh, dear, I'm booked out.
Hurry up, more. I'm in the bath.
I won't look. Are you the police?
No, I'm the station master. I'll get him.
Good.
Hello, constable here.
You were the station master.
I was, but I changed me hat.
Oh. The child Harold has been stolen.
What? Little Harold?
Little Harold.
The light of Flynn Street gone? I'll save him, Ma. Now then, any unusual marks on his body there?
Yes, he has a pair of legs that don't reach the ground.
So, we're looking for a lad with a space underneath. I'll save him, Mum. Click.
Click?
Yeah, I'm hanging up.
Oh. Come round and cut you down then.
Hello, folks, calling folks. It's Neddie again. We now perchance about two men reclining in a deserted crow's nest, listening to a deserted wireless program.
Up. Yes, it's Bert Trusser and his late night gold and silver strings. At this time of the year, it's when a young man's fancy turns to love. And well, yes, this young man's fancy turned to love. And lovely Tom Link sings, I never knew what love could do. And here it is, and it's called...
I stood on the cliffs at dawn. I stood on the cliffs as the wind blew. And it...
We interrupt that splash to give you a police message. The child Harold is missing. A reward of 4 shillings a pound will be paid for his body's return. At the kidnapping, the child weighed 16 stone.
Sixteen stone and 4 shillings a pound. That's £45 reward, Moriarty.
With that money, I can afford to stand up. £45. Will
you be keep? Will you be? Will you... Please, Moriarty. Keep still. Do you want us both out of this suit? Ah. We must plan a plan during this rendering of Max Geldray's conch.
Oh, boy, my conch is still making the headlines. Plugy!
Conch has spoken.
Thank you. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.